Nous allons parler de végétation aquatique dans les cours d'eau.
We're going to discuss water plants in waterways. A few definitions, a few reminders on basic ecology, so that you can understand how this vegetation can be used as a bioindicator. Aquatic macrophytes. This term is a classification, a functional classification, not based on the knowledge of flowers. And this covers all plants that have a macroscopic aspect. They can be seen with the naked eye in the water, as opposed to microphytes. Macrophytes are phanerogams, for instance, the plants with flowers. Some of them are totally immersed, some of them are floating, or some have floating leaves. Some have their roots in substrate, but the leaves are outside of the water and they are called helophytes. Bryophytes are also included in the macrophyte class with hepatics and mosses. And there are also colonies of algae made of unicellular organisms, but they can be seen because they gather together, so they will be considered as large plants because they can be seen as the large plants can be. Just so you understand, a few illustrations of phanerogams, Sparganium immersum with the leaves and flowers out of the water, Ranunculus penicillatus in the water, Potamogeton nodosus floating on the surface, bryophytes also such as mosses with the very common Fontinalis, hepatics with flowers and leaves, and algae which may form colonies and carpets on the bottom of the waterway. Some of them are more discreet, Catophora batrachospermum, which can be found on the left-hand side and are present only in very small, cool water rivers. Now, these vegetations have very strong interactions with their habitat. Exchanges take place in all kinds of compartments with water, with sediments, with the atmosphere, and the exchanges will allowed to exchange nutrients or gases. The exchanges take place in a different way depending on the shape of the plant. The shape of the plant is not only a description, it also plays a very specific role in the ecosystem. We also have payback actions that these macrophytes have with their habitat, local changes in the way the water flows or changes in the sediments. These vegetation species play a central role in the aquatic ecosystem. They are primary producers and they serve as basis for the trophic network, but they also structure the habitat in other ecosystem compartments such as invertebrates or fishes. All the vegetation is conditioned by a number of factors, managing the environment, geochemistry, nutrients, substrate, and its morphodynamic lighting, and occupation of the banks, hydrology, hydraulic or thermic measurements. How can they be used as indicators? For this, we need to go back to more basic knowledge on ecology, the response of the species to the ecological factors in the environment. This is the notion of ecologic valency, which was described at the beginning of the 20th century. For a given ecological factor, such as temperature or ammonium content or mineralization, some species will respond with very for very specific value of the gradient, either low values or very high values. These are steoids species, very sensitive indicators. Other species will be far less sensitive or susceptible, much more tolerant, and they are called urias species. One other aspect of this vegetation, other factors may be used to characterize the structure of the vegetation, its composition, what kind of species compose the vegetation, the number of species, the fairness, the balance between the various the fair balance between the species, the abundance, and ecological and biological traits, which can also be used as a slightly more sophisticated criteria to describe the structure. For instance, we have seen earlier that the way they grow can also be an ecological trait. Bioindication tools. What is a bioindicator? Bioindicator is an organism or a part of an organism or a group of organisms which can be used
connaître l'état de son environnement,
to describe the status of the environment it lives in, the habitat. For microphytic indicators in the rivers, an indicator was developed in the 90s, IBMR, Biological Index, Microphytic Index in Rivers, based on two main aspects, the composition of the vegetation, which species are present, and the relative abundance of the species composing the vegetation. How is the indicator built? 208 aquatic taxons were chosen in order to calculate the indicator. 208 taxons, which really cover most of the aquatic species that can be found in French waterways. Two values were set for these taxons, a specific value expressed from 0 to 20, and a Steno-OEC coefficient, i.e. the taxon's capacity to provide a rather accurate value on a gradient of the trophic level. We have seen earlier that there is a notion called the ecological valency. The monometric index is expressed as a single value, single measurement covering all of the trophic level. You can see in the formula on the bottom right-hand side that this value is calculated as the average of a specific measurements of all the present taxons weighted out, depending on the abundance and the Steno-OEC value of each of the taxons. Now, how do we use this kind of indicator to assess the ecological status? Early 2000, a European directive was implemented, and we had to develop a method with bioindicators. Here we have aquatic vegetation. Measurements, hydrologic measurements are made. Macrophytes are taken from a river based on a very standardized protocol. And based on these sampling, an indicator is calculated. Here, in this case, the IBMR. And the reference value is 9.8. The value must be brought closer to the reference set of references. One of the very first methods for us was to work on the reference value so that we could have IBMR reference scores for each of the type of river that can be found in France. In our example, the reference value is 12, and based on this, we calculate deviation from the reference value by calculating the ratio of the observed value on the reference value 0.82 in this case. Then we use a matrix, the thresholds of which have been defined when we elaborated the method, and we see that we have a green class, and a green class is a good ecological state. We can thus show synthetically the status of the waterways for all of France. As you can see on the right-hand side, we see the macrophytic quality of waterways in France from this map. The same approach was used for all of the biological elements that can contribute to defining the ecological status according to the European directive. Now, what about the future for these bioindicators? In which direction are these indicators going to go for further research? On these two examples, we can see the results from work conducted by the ERSTIA teams of researchers in Bordeaux, trying to define more sophisticated indicators which will respond to a kind of stimulation in a more accurate way. On the left-hand side, we have the synthetic representation of ecological profiles, providing a quick look on the affinity for a given level of parameters. Take, for instance, the profiles described here on the left-hand side series. We have physico-chemical parameters. On the right-hand side series, we have hydromorphologic parameters. Another kind of result is shown by the right-hand side graph,
des résultats
we
assez
may
nets,
see
en fait, de,
obvious results from a series of statistical
des,
analysis
métriques environnementales avec
in order
des métriques
to compare environmental measurements with biological measurements. And here the measurement
rouge,
is the IBMR,
net,
so it's a global measurement. In red, we have a negative response on this indicator based on
bleu,
light and mineralization factors, whereas in blue, we have the positive replies. Especially regarding hydrodynamism of the substrate.
Que peut-on retenir
what will be the take-home message from this very simplified approach to the way macrophytes can be used as my bioindicators? That macrophytic vegetations are a good indicator of the biodiversity, the wealth of an aquatic environment. We can also remember that this macrophytic vegetation is conditioned by all of the mechanisms managed the environment, and as a consequence, they also have an influence on other habitats. Vegetation describing parameters will provide data regarding the ecological status of a system and the impact on these systems from all kinds of stimulations and entropic pressures from the catchment area.